Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. How are you doing, everyone? And welcome to Advent 2, our second week. As you can see from the opening scene, we have our Advent wreath here in our little chapel at Church of the Nativity, a stewardship parish in Midland Park, New Jersey. And the readings are classic and they're great. And I sang that song because those are the words that we hear that come from the prophet Isaiah that talk about John's proclaiming that Jesus is coming, that this Savior is coming into the world. And it says, a voice has cried out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight all of your paths. You know, we use that word so often in our lives, you know, we talk about that word. And what does that mean, make straight your paths? But we think of it in how we use it today in a very contemporary way. We use it in the sense of, hey, listen, I want some straight talk, or I want you to stand up straight and look me in the eyes, or look me straight in the eyes. We use this in all different types of ways. And so what that really means is we want to cut through all the fluff and we want to get to the core of what's important. For John the Baptist, following Jesus was very clear and very simple. It was repentance. It was looking at our lives and asking God to forgive us for all the things that we are doing in our lives that we know that we shouldn't be, that we know are sinful. And when we get that in place, then we are able to experience and see the salvation of God in a way that we've never seen it before. And so therefore, that's what's important for each one of us to do. And Advent is a great time for that. You know, it's an opportunity for us to look at all the things that keep us from experiencing God in its fullness. You know, when we're moody, when we're uppity, when we're arrogant, when we're self-deprecating, when we're even vulgar at times, we affect those relationships around us. And what John the Baptist is saying to all of us is that we have to come and reconcile ourselves with God, because it gives us an opportunity to reconcile ourselves with God, with ourselves, and with others. We all have those relationships in our lives that need healing. We all have things in our lives and behaviors that we know we shouldn't be doing. And that's what John is calling us to this in this week's gospel, to say, look at yourself, prepare yourself for the coming. And what we prepare ourselves in celebrating this feast of the Nativity of our Lord Jesus. So I invite you to come here to Church of the Nativity and be with us as we do this together, because that's the great part too. We don't do it on our own. And we have some wonderful things that are coming up in the parish that I think will really help you reflect on that and look at yourself and look at where you're at with God, with yourself, and with others in the next coming weeks. This weekend, we have Father John Gabriel, who's preaching at all the masses. But even more important, we have a great Advent mission next Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Okay, so the 10th, 11th, and 12th of December at 7:30 p.m. in the church. 1 hour, that's all we're asking you for. I guarantee you, come at least one day, but we'd love to see you for 3 days. And then we have on the 16th of December, we have our Christmas concert, which is a Sunday evening at 7 o'clock. It promises to be something that will truly lift your spirit and put you in the mood. And then on December 22nd, we have our communal pen service that we do with several of the churches in the surrounding area. This year, we're doing our communal Advent penance service at St. Luke's Church in Hohokus at 12 noon. And so we invite you to be part of that with us, because again, what a better way to give ourselves a gift this Christmas than to have everything clean and ready to be open to all that God has to offer us and all that God wants to give us. And lastly, I want you to put on your calendars January 6th at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, or 2:30. I'm not exactly sure what time it is, but we have our Epiphany pageant with our children here, and it is great for What Ails You. It is just a great moment in our church where we can just listen to the whole story of the Christmas season and what it means through the eyes and the voices of our children. And for any of you out there that haven't gotten your children signed up yet, please do so right away, because we still have some things that they can do, and we'd love to have them part of this. Once again, I hope your Advent is something that is fruitful and rewarding for all of you. And know that we are here praying for you. Please come and pray with us. God bless you.